Hi guys, it's Micah. Today I'm back with some alcohol inks and I tried to make a watercolor meadow-like thing. And these are the results. There's another one which I trashed, to be honest. I have pulled out my grubby older cutting board, so in case I get it all dirty like this Teflon sheet, I wouldn't mind as much on my new cutting board. And I am doing the ink block printing, acrylic block printing, smooshing, whatever you want to call it. And you might know it because you would take your mini ink cubes and just press on inks and then spray it with water. Instead, here I have alcohol in a little beaker. And I've pulled out a range of alcohol inks. That's the only brand I have, by the way, Adirondacks. Raspberry, currant, watermelon, honeycomb, botanical, lettuce and stream for greens, and sailboat blue and mermaid for my sky. And I just randomly apply it in thirds on my block, as if that's the sky. Blue goes up there and green for the stalks of my wildflowers go on the bottom. And they mix and max it, it's okay, because then it gets more random and also more wild. And this is currant, I believe. I just dotted around here and there, honeycomb. And that was poppy field, I could get it open, so I went for raspberry and watermelon, because I didn't want to go get up and go and get my really big pliers. So that's alcohol, so I spray it like I would do with water, and you can try and move it with your brush, but it tends to go very muddy very quickly, so don't do that, frankly. And you see, you can move it and you can also, you know, blow a little bit and then drop your upo that slips because it's wet. It's very random. Watercolor, of course, is never precise. So if you want a precise look, this probably is not for you. And there's some color left on my ink block, so I thought I would stamp it again on another piece of upo paper. But it's actually synthetic paper. Upo is a brand, but it's not that. And to put my meadow together, I die cut Sizzik Thin Knits from Tim Holtz, and they are called 661190, which I think they're called wildflowers as well here and there. I've seen them advertised as such, but I use the ones with a more open structure. You see, I'm trying to fix that there, but I decided to put a flower on top, so you but you can see already you have the green of the stalks and the very 3D painted flowers. It's like an impressionist painting from that era. I mean, not that I'm an artist, but I try. And it's just fun, you know, because I like the free and the flowiness of watercolors, but I thought I can, you know, experiment a little bit more with my alcohol inks, and I have done just that. I've die cut these from black cardstock with double-sided tape on the back. And some have die cut more successfully than others, and there's still bits stuck inside that I'm trying to pick off and remove to the side. So I did speed this up 300%, so three times. Just because this was a bit fiddly. But the fun of upo paper is that it's plastic, of course, or synthetic, so you can kind of remove it. It's a really funny story. I bought this set of Thin Knits because of the stamps that are in there with the little bulbs. I'm not sure which herbs these are. I like the open texture, and all the others are fun as well, of course, but just not as pretty, I think, for this method. Because I thought if I make blobs of color in the background and then put flowers on top, then it would look like the flowers are in red. And the one that I'm, of course, I put on first with the very high in the blue was just to disguise that blob. And these ones, they didn't match my other flowers, so I removed them, put them on the other one, the fainter, and then I removed them all together and I thought, I'm not doing it. I don't have many silhouette stamps because you might know I like to color things. And I use silhouette stamps sometimes in mixed media or artist trading coins situations more than kind of these. And I like these because they were see-through, but they didn't go with the other ones. I don't know. I don't think they're from the same set, actually. I'm not sure where they are from. They don't show up on the packaging. So I'm not entirely sure. Oops, sorry, I dropped that. But I stuck them all together in one package, so now I don't know anymore. So I went and die cut another one of those bigger stalks and just put it lower. Sorry. And then just cut off the bits and bobs. And for a sentiment, I haven't decided yet. I pulled out the Tim Holtz Chit Chat stickers. But I didn't. I think I like it, you know, without words on it. A banner, maybe. But I think it's busy as it is, and I don't do busy. Not very well, anyway. But yeah. See this one, I didn't like the front, I didn't like the flowers, I just peeled them off, and now we'll use the background in my second card that's coming up, where I did pull out all my silhouette stamps. And I'll just put it on a card, that's fine. I will think about if I need it for an occasion, I can always put a sentiment on the inside today, so. I like this acrylic block because it's almost card size. But I had ink not moving as much, I think, as I thought it would. So I have two, kind of like ends that are still white. I cut them off, but you see the card base. So maybe I should have done them black. I don't know. I could have left it because now it's white cardstock instead of white Yupo paper. So, and this is pretty much the same. I just put green and blue and then the colors in the middle in little dots. And I think the more random you go, the better. And you can see how much they spread on dry acrylic. Actually, I didn't put any alcohol on it like you would have to do with water, just to make the inks move and bloom and such. So I'm just putting the same colors, actually. Watermelon, currant, raspberry, this is honeycomb. And then I thought maybe I can print it like this, but then it would have all those hard edges. And so I decided to spray it anyway. And I'm using the other side of the paper. Because, you know, you don't want to waste your synthetic paper. Yupo is quite expensive. And I found a cheaper brand. So I'm already happy with that. But I still want to be frugal. Also because I don't like waste. I hate it when it goes into the landfill. And there's so much trash already. It really does my head in. But look how pretty it is. It's so vibrant and so yummy. And here I try to fill up the color bit there, and the second print for me didn't really do much, so I've decided not to even bother with this. You can, of course, I mean, I thought it wasn't worth the effort. And here I'm showing you which ones I use, but I already named them. So the stream botanicals, silver blue, mermaid, lettuce, and currant, poppy, watermelon, honeycomb, raspberry. But any colors that you have, of course, will work because the flowers can be any color. If you wanna go, yeah, I like it. It looks like it's windswept as well because of that thing on the top there. And as I said, it looks very impressionist style painting, and you can leave it as it is actually. You don't have to stamp anything on top. And these are very wild flowers. This is a new one I got the other week. This one looks very much like coral, but this side to me looks like it could be just above water. And I did this want to know, it's Studio Light is a Dutch company, which doesn't matter of course, you can probably get them everywhere, but it's called Stamp OV370, and you get a 6x6 stamp with two really big stamps in there, and the little lady is stamp SL355, and the dandelion, if you want to know, is 351, also stamp SL351. And I stamped them with Stazon. And this stamp is a little bit distressed in the way it is supposed to print. But I still stamp it a few times just to get a good impression. It's a really big stamp, of course, and that's why a stamping tool is very handy. Also because Yupo paper or synthetic paper is slippery, and that's why I'm using Stazon. Just otherwise I don't think it will dry. And I'm cleaning my stems right away because I don't want the Stazon to make them all black and horrible. I know it doesn't affect the stems very much, but I don't like it. So yeah, this is pretty much the most meadowy flower. The other ones were from Nelly Snellen. I've used them on an artist trading coins, and I liked the little lady. She didn't stamp very well. So I filled it in later with, I would have used my Sharpie, but I don't know where it is. I think it's in my travel bag. So I pulled out Spectrum Noir Black, True Black marker, and filled in the little bits that didn't stamp properly. And in these open flowers, it doesn't really matter. I think, it, you know, because the background is also distressed and has like bits missing. But with a lady that chasing butterflies, I think it's important that she's at least solid, you know. And I think there was something on her face because it left a little hole in her cheek. So I just filled it in with a marker, and you can't really see it unless you look for it. And again, I left out the sentiment because I don't know what to put on it. Maybe Happy Mother's Day. Like, I don't see my mother, if she were still alive, I don't see her dancing in a meadow chasing butterflies, but you know, I don't do that myself either. I no, maybe when I was 5, but yeah, it could be Mother's Day, I don't know. I'm just rationalizing here, so filling the time as well. And I'm happy it's finally sunny. And I'm going outside in a bit when I finish this. See? I like the vibrancy. That's why I use Talens Ecolina a lot. Because they're also so vibrant. But this this alcohol ink is very, very vibrant as well. And I love it. And you saw me pulling out my little holder there, pen holder. That was where the Sharpie should have been, but it's not. And I do workshop once in a while, and I need to take half my craft room with me, and then stuff gets displaced. I should put them back, but I don't, because of what I have another workshop next week or the week after, or yeah, so I don't see the point. So here's where I'm cut off the little edges that didn't have any ink on it. And yeah, I wonder why now, but it made sense at that time. sometimes you think, oh, yeah, I love it. And you know, we put the flowers on top, and the color that's behind it gives you the hint that there's more flowers in the meadow or in the background, I think. But might be just me seeing that, but I hope you see it too. So yeah, I'm just sticking it on. And here, maybe I should have done black, I don't know. Or may make the edges more prominent. But yeah, I still like him, and I don't know what occasion that will go for, but I hope I will see you again soon. Thank you for watching, and bye!